morning, dears. How are you? I hope everybody is fine and happy. Yes. Today we are going to see a new chapter. Okay. The topic is mensuration. You would have not heard about this word, but you would have studied more things on this. See, what is mensuration? The part of geometry concerned with ascertaining length, area and volume. Imagine if I have a box like this, okay. Can you say what is this? You can say the shape of this is rectangle. And what is this box? A full box? It is a cuboid, isn't it so? So, for this, we are going to find the length, breadth, okay. And what is this inside spaces? Area and how much it can hold is volume. So, these things we are going to study in this chapter. Here we are going to study very little initial things we are going to study about mensuration. First thing what we are going to study is perimeter. What is perimeter? Perimeter means go around once. Peri means go around. Okay. So if I want to measure this, what I have to do? I have to add all the measures and go around once. Understand? Then I can measure easily. If I want to measure, I take a scale, I'll measure everything and write it. Is it so? So likewise, can we add one thing? See, I have a given a figure here. Okay, you can also take your book page number 207. 207. Here there are some pictures given to find the perimeter. So perimeter means what? You are going to add once, isn't it? So shall we add once? So the perimeter is what? AB, then for BC plus CD plus DA. All the things we are going to add. So shall we add the measures? What is the measure for AB is what? 40 centimeter. Then BC is 10 centimeter. Then CD is 40 centimeter. And DA is 10 centimeter. So total you can add 40 plus 10 is 50. Okay. 40 plus 10 is 50. 50 plus 50 is what? 100 centimeter. Okay. So this is the answer for the first figure. The rest of the things you can complete in the book itself. You can add it and write it. That's all. You have to add all the measures without mistake and to write the answers there. Right? Fine. Next, we are going to see perimeter of a rectangle. Okay, here we instead of adding like this, so it is a very small measures, we can add easily, isn't it? Imagine your father wants to put a fence for your house, your compound wall. Okay, he want to measure, by keep on measuring, it's a lengthy time. It takes lot of time, isn't it dear? So for that, we can make a precise of it. How to make it precise? That I'll teach you now. So you can, we can derive a formula for this. So how to derive a formula? So you know that here it is already written as A, B, BC, CD and DA, isn't it? That you can take it and write it. So the perimeter of a rectangle is equal to what? Sum of the length. Okay, sum of the lengths of its four sides. So rectangle has four sides, isn't it? So here when we add these things, what I get? AB plus BC plus CD plus DA, that we did before the sum, isn't it? So after that, you know that we can make a little change. Okay, how to make a little change? So AB is equal to CD. Can I say AB as again an AB? Yes, both is, centimeters are same, 15 centimeter, 15 centimeter. So I can make AB plus BC plus CD as again AB plus DA. Can I say it again as BC? Yes, both the centimeters are what? Same. You know the property of rectangle is what? Opposite sides are equal. So I can say that as BC. They are equal, isn't it? Only the name is different. So I can make it what? 2 times AB, 1, 2. Okay, plus 2 times BC. Shall I write like this? Yes. So this shows the distributive property you have studied before. Yes. So that in that way, I make it short. I take 2 as common. If I take 2 as common, I get AB plus BC. Is it okay? Yes. So, this can be said as what? AB is what? 15 centimeters. So, that I take this as, this is AB is what? Length. So, I can write it as 2 into length plus B is what? BC is what? Breadth. Okay. So, I made it as the perimeter of a rectangle is equal to, formula is 2 into L plus B. 2 into L plus B. Shall I make that a short form? Yes. So, perimeter of a rectangle is what? Is equal to 2 into L plus B. L plus B. Units. Unit means if it is given centimeter, you have to write centimeter. If you want to write meter, you have to write the meter. Here you can substitute now. 2 into L is 15 centimeter plus B is what? 9 centimeter. So if you add this, what do you get? You get 24 centimeter. So that is equal to 2 into 24 centimeter. So that is equal to, you multiply, you get 48 centimeter. That is the answer of this rectangle. So the perimeter of this rectangle is equal to 48 centimeter. So what is the formula? Again, I repeat, 2 into L plus B units. This you keep it in mind. This measures, if it varies, no problem. You can substitute for L and B and find the answer. Understand? So if here it is given 25 and here if it is given 8, easily you can do it. 25 plus 8 into 2. That's all. You'll get the answer. Right? So, instead of keep on measuring, go around and measuring, this formula will help you to find the answer very easily. Okay. Likewise, we are going to do this sum. Okay. So, how to do this sum? The lid of a rectangular box of side 40 cm by 10 cm is sealed around with tape. Okay. What is the length of the tape required? So, here it is given what? So, imagine this box. Okay, so this is what? 40 centimeter, and this is, imagine this is 10 centimeter. Okay, I want to wrap this with a tape. I take a cello tape and I want to wrap this all around. Okay, what is they are asking is the length of the tape required. How much I will need this tape? Okay, so for that, what I will do is you take a measurement, isn't it? So 40 centimeters length and 10 centimeters breadth. So that you have to take it and write it. Now what we have to do is, you have to take and write the length. So length of the lid. So length of the lid is equal to how much? 40 centimeter. And width or breadth, both the words are same. Okay, width of the lid is equal to 10 centimeter. Okay, so the length of the tape required is equal to, you know the formula, isn't it? Easily you can do it. How to do it? Yeah, you can do it easily. 2 into, yeah, length is 40 plus breadth is 10. All centimeters should be written. Okay, centimeter. Okay, fine. So that is equal to, this is called what? Perimeter of the rectangle, isn't it? Perimeter of the rectangle. So that I can easily multiply and write. You know that 40 plus 10 is 50. So 2 into 50 centimeter is equal to, 2 into 50 is what? 100. Very good. 100 centimeter is the answer. So answer is what? The length of the tape required is how much? 100 centimeter. Good. Now, fifth question. A rectangular piece of land measures 0.57 km by 0.5 km. Each side is to be fenced with 4 rows of wires. Okay. What is the length of the wire needed? Same thing. Imagine a rectangular piece. Your this thing. Okay. In this measure, it have 0.5 km. Okay. And 0.5 km. Okay. Each side is to be fenced with four rows of wire. Four rows you need to measure. See, imagine this is one row. One full line is measured. Next, again, the you have to measure it and row. So, likewise, you have to measure four times. Four rows. Okay. So, first we have to find for one row how much it happens. So, if you want to do it, first you have to find it. So, length of the piece of the land is how much? Length is what? 0.7 kilometer. And breadth is what? 0.5 kilometer. This is given. Okay. First, what is given and what is needed? You have to write it. So, what is given? So, length of the piece of land is equal to 0.7 kilometer. Next, length or breadth of is equal to 0.5 kilometer. Okay, so both are given. Next, perimeter of the land we want, isn't it? Yeah. Perimeter of the land, you know what is the thing? 2 into L plus B. Okay, L plus B. Here it is, the unit is what? Kilometer. So, just substitute here. So, 2 into L is 0.7 plus 0.5 kilometer. So, 0.7 plus 0.5. When you add, what do you get? This will become 12. So, 1 carry over 1. So, decimal after 1 digit. Decimal after 1 digit. So, it is what? 2 into 1.2. Is it okay? 1.2 kilometers. Okay, fine. So, that is equal to, just you multiply. What do you get? 2 2s of 4.21 is 2. So, 2.4 kilometers is the answer for what? That is equal to 1 times the length of the wire needed for 1 time. Okay. Needed for 1 time. Now, we have found for one time, but the question is for what? Four rows are there. So, we have to write it for four times. So, what will happen? What is your answer for it? This is 2.4 kilometer for one time. Therefore, 2.4 into 4 you have to do it. So, what do you get? 4 4s are 16, carry over 1. 4 2s are 8 plus 1, 9. So, decimal after a dot. So, 9.6 kilometers is the answer for this. So, how will you write it this? So, this is the four times thing. You can write like this. The total length of the wire needed. Total length of the wire needed is equal to 2.4 into 4. That you can write it as what? Four times the perimeter. Okay. The one perimeter is what? 2.4. Four times the perimeter. So, that what we have written, 2.4 kilometer into 4. So, that is equal to 9.6 kilometer. Okay. So, I hope you can understand this. Right. Next, we will go for the next thing. See here. Find the perimeter of each of the thing. A, B, C is given. First one is triangles of sides are given. Then, equilateral triangle of side 9 centimeter and isosceles triangle. Okay, you know what is this, isn't it? We have studied in the lesson 4, right? Yes. So, here we are going to add all those things. What is given? The perimeter. Okay. So, first we will start with the question 6. The perimeter of the triangle is equal to what? So, the perimeter of the triangle is equal to, you can add it, 3 centimeter plus 4 centimeter plus 5 centimeter. So, all the four measures are different. It means what is the type of triangle? Yes. Okay. Scalene triangle. Isn't it? So, if you add 5 plus 4 is 9. 9 plus 3 is 12. 12 centimeter is the answer. Now, same thing. If it is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means the word equal itself. It means that all the three sides are equal. So, if you want, you can draw the triangle. All the three sides are equal. So, I take this as what? 9 centimeter, 9 centimeter, 9 centimeter. So, instead of adding 9 plus 9 plus 9, I can say it was what? Equilateral triangle, 3 times the sides. Okay. Yes. So it is what? 3 × 9 cm. That is equal to 9 × 3 = 27 cm. Is it clear, dear? So all the three sides are equal, so that I don't want to add like this. Am I right? All the three sides are equal means I make it as 3 × sides. So it becomes what? 3 × 1 side is 9 cm. So it is 27 cm. Same thing, if the isosceles triangle with equal sides 8 cm with each and third side is 6 cm. Isosceles means what? Two sides are equal, the third side is different, isn't it here? So I can make it as a small statement like this. I can make 2 × length of equal side plus the third side. Yes, can I make like this? Yes. So 2 × the equal side is what? 8 cm. So I take 8 cm plus the third side is what? 6 cm. Yes, fine. So now I can add this easily. 8 + 2 is what? 16 cm plus 6 cm. So I make it as, now you can add this 16 plus 6 will become what? 22 cm. Yes, fine. So by this you can easily understand how to frame a perimeter formula, isn't it dear? For square you can make it as all the four sides are equal, so 4 × s. Here the three sides are equal, 3 × s. If it is hexagon, pentagon of equal side means you can write 5 × s. Hexagon means it has 6 sides, so 6 × the sides. So likewise you can frame your own formulas. Okay, so here see, find the perimeter of a regular hexagon with each sides of perimeter is 8 meters. You can directly write the answer. So hexagon means what? It's all what? It's a 6-sided figure, isn't it dear? Yes. It's a tessellation figure. So like honeycomb, isn't it? So it has a strong base, hexagon. So hexagon, you know that it is 8 meters. All the sides are 8 meters. So it means that what? 6 sides are 8 meters. All the 6 sides are 8 meters. So I can make it as 6 × sides. Okay. So that is equal to what? 6 × 8. So it is what? 48 cm. Is it okay, dear? So by seeing itself, if it is a one mark question, you can write 8 × 6. Directly you can write the answer. Right? Fine. Now we can go to the 11th question. So rest of the thing, what I am leaving is of same model. You can do it as a homework, right? So the piece of string is 30 cm long. What will be the length of each side of the string is used to form a square, a equilateral triangle, a rectangular hexagon. So here the one measure is given, a string, iron string. Okay, imagine that. You want to frame a shape on that. Okay, so first shape is square, second is equilateral triangle, third is a regular hexagon. So you know that we have come across this formula. So what you have to do? For square, you want to make it into equal sides, isn't it? Square means it is what? 4 sides, isn't it dear? Yeah. So here we don't know that 4 × s sides is given as what? 30 cm. Perimeter is given. Okay. This is given as what? The perimeter is given. We are going to find the side. One side we are going to find. Understand here? So this is, we don't know. This we don't know. But the total thing we know. The total length of the wire is given. This total length is given as 30 cm. But we don't know what is one side. So to find one side, what you have to do? Keep the side and take the 4 down. Understand? So when you take this down, it will become what? The side is equal to 30 cm divided by 4. Understand here? So you can divide, isn't it? 30 divided by 4 is equal to 4 sevens are 28. So take it is balances 2. Point, keep point and put 0. Understand? Keep a decimal point and put 0. So 4 fives are 20. So what you get? That is equal to 7.5. It is what? Centimeter. Okay, so you have to read the question carefully. The piece of the string is 30 cm long. So it means that it is the perimeter. Okay, what will be the length of each side of the string. So side we don't know. We have found out that one side is 7.5 centimeter. It means all the four sides are what? 7.5 centimeter. Is it clear, dear? Fine. Now imagine it's an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle, you know that. What is that? 3 in the sides, isn't it, dear? 3 into sides is equal to 30 centimeter. S is equal to, I write side as S. So 30 centimeter divided by 3. So you know that 3 ones are 3, 3 tens are 30. So that is equal to 10 centimeter. Fine. Next, for regular hexagon. Hexagon, now we saw it is what? 6-sided figure, isn't it? So 6 into side is equal to what? 30 centimeter. S is equal to 30 centimeter divided by 6. So what do you get? 6 ones are 6, 6 fives are 30. S is equal to 5 centimeter. So the same string, with the same string, we have made 3 different shapes, but the sides are different. Understand? So for square it is 7 centimeter, for equilateral triangle it's 10 centimeter, and for hexagon it is 5 centimeter. I hope you can understand this easily. Okay, fine. Now here, find the cost of the fencing of a square park outside 250 meter at the rate of rupees 20 per meter. You know that the square park, one side is given as 250 meters. So here I had a square, I am having a square 250 meter. So all the four sides are 250 meter. Here they are asking, they want to fence it. Fence means compound. So it has a cost for rupees 20. Okay. So what I will do, find the perimeter of the square park first. So the perimeter of a square park, we have to find it out now. So you know the side, isn't it? The side of the square park is equal to how much, dear? 250 meter. The perimeter of the square park is what? 4 into side, isn't it, dear? 4 into side. So that is equal to 4 into 250 meter. So that is equal to 254 times is what? Anyone can say? 25 into 4 is what? 100. So 250 into 4 is what? Very good. It is what? 1000 meter. Understand? So 1000 meter we have found out. Now it is given. This is for what? 1 meter they are given. We have found out, isn't it? For rupees 20 per meter we are going to spend. Here how much meter is there? 1000 meter is there. So you can multiply this into 20. So what is the rupees we have to find out, isn't it? So the cost of fencing. The cost of fencing a square park is equal to how much you want to find out? It's about rupees 20 into 1000. Okay. So what will happen? You count the zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Isn't it? 4 zeros. 2 ones are 2. So it is 20,000 rupees is needed to fence that park. Is it clear, dear? Yes. By this, you can understand this exercise. The rest of the sums, you can do it as homework. If you have any doubt, please do call me. I'll help you. Okay. Thank you, dears. Bye.